So the last topic we're going to discuss is geometric transformations. And unlike what you might have done in your geometry class, geometric transformations on the SAT are not that involved, and they're pretty rare. As we're going to see with symmetry, you might see a problem on symmetry, which we'll talk about near the end of this video. But in general, if you're familiar with geometric transformations, and you will be by the end of this video, you should be good to go. So the first transformation to talk about is a translation. And a translation that's not, you know, a translating from another language, though you might be able to see the interesting connection between that and this idea, if you think about it. But translation is just moving. It's moving a shape. So let's say we had some coordinate axes. That is not good. Coordinate axes. And let's say we had a square that was graphed on it. Let's say I translated it to down 3 units. What would that look like? Well, it would just be the square moved down 3 units. So maybe it would look something like this. That's all a translation is. It's a movement. And it keeps, the important thing though is it keeps the, even though this one got bigger, it really shouldn't have, it keeps the dimensions of the actual object the same. It doesn't change the shape of it or the size of it or anything like that, even though I screwed up the picture here. The one that this one really isn't on the test, but the one that does change the size, so say we had a triangle, and let's say it became this. This is a dilation. And actually, what's interesting, when we dilate this triangle, what do we have but similar triangles? So similar triangles, or any kind of similar polygon, is just a dilated polygon, either, you know, getting bigger or getting smaller. Anyway, moving back towards the topic. So rotation, as you might expect, is rotating or moving around a central point. So let's say we had this figure. How about this? North, south, east, west. What if I rotated this 90 degrees this way? Well, what would this look like? It would look like this. North, west, south, east, right? I just turned this thing about this central point 90 degrees. If I turned it 45 degrees, it would look something like this, right? North, west, south, east, right? I just moved it from this original position 45 degrees, and that's a rotation. Reflect means to create a mirror image given some kind of line of reflection. So in this case, if we have this rectangle, actually let's make this weird. No, that's not good. I need to have it a little bit. Let's see. I got an idea. Let's say we had this shape and I wanted to reflect it over this line right here. What would it look like over here? Well, to reflect it means just to take the mirror image, right? It would just be look like this. Right? This would be the reflection. And again, if you reflected it back, it would just become its original picture. Finally, symmetry. So this is a reflection, actually. Let me just write that in. Reflection. Finally, symmetry. This is one you might actually see occasionally. Symmetry, it just talks about how, you know, the harmony or balance or the equality between different halves, essentially. Well, that's a really great definition of symmetry. I mean, let me look up a good definition of symmetry. Let's see. Wikipedia says, symmetry generally conveys two primary meanings. The first is an imprecise sense of a harmonious or aesthetically pleasing proportionality and balance. That's what I was referring to. The second meaning is a precise and well-defined concept of balance or pattern self-similarity. All right. Whatever. I think that's a little bit confusing. I think it's better if we just, you know, look at some examples. So what would be a symmetrical thing? Well, let's take a look at, say, a rectangle. A rectangle has a couple lines of symmetry, right? Or actually, multiple lines of symmetry. Right? Here's one, right? Everything on this side is the same as on this side. In fact, it's almost as if you had reflected this in that side. This is also a line of symmetry, right? What's on this side right here is the same as what's on this side on the bottom. Let's see. Again, it's about reflection. If you reflected this over here, you would get this side. So it's actually related to reflection a little bit. One other kind of symmetry is point symmetry, which is essentially rotation. We need an example here. Maybe this triangle, this equilateral triangle. This would have point symmetry because if you rotated this 120 degrees, you would get the same triangle, right? It would look the same. So this one's actually related to rotations. You can have rotational symmetry, or in this case, point symmetry. Where will this come up? often I've seen problems where they'll say, you know, here are five letters. Which of the following does not have any symmetry? Does not have a line or any kind of symmetry? Well, this one has symmetry here, right? This has symmetry here. This has symmetry here. This has symmetry here, here, and rotational. And actually also here and here. Lots of lines of symmetry for that x. What about the r? Well, listen, it can't be split here. Can't be cut here. No thing here, nothing here. No rotational symmetry. So there is no symmetry. So the answer here would be r. That is maybe what you might see for a kind of transformations or symmetry problem. And that's pretty much all you need to know about transformations. And that is the end of our geometry section of the boot camp. Next, we're going to finish up with data analysis, statistics, probability, just kind of the random stuff you might see on the SAT associated with those topics.